the relationship with my grandfather and my grandmother, Patsy and Conchetta, with Frank Sinatra, was a very amicable one, one of friendship that grew stronger throughout the years, mutual respect, and grandma and grandpa were the kind of people, my grandparents were the kind of people that they loved you no matter what. And one of the most famous stories that I remember my grandfather telling me was when Frank was down and out. It was before From Here to Eternity. It's when he broke up with Ava Gardner. It's when he lost the record deal. Frank was in the day before Thanksgiving, and he was by himself because normally the people that were in the dining room would clamor to buy him a drink or buy him dinner or something. And he said to my grandfather at that point, he said, "Patsy, you see all these people here? They're my fair weather friends. They only come to me when the sun is shining." In other words, he was down and out. That's when no one cared about him. And that's when my grandparents were at their best. They stepped up and they were his friends even more so. And he asked my grandfather, the next day was Thanksgiving, he said, "Patsy, I want to come in tomorrow. Book me a table for one." My grandfather had signs throughout the restaurant that they were closed on Thanksgiving Day, but he didn't have the heart to tell Frank that they were closed the next day. And he could have very well invited him to his house for Thanksgiving, but he didn't want to hurt Frank's pride. Frank had been to the house before as well. So he took the signs down. He told all his employees that tomorrow you got to come in for work. And they were moaning and groaning. He said, "Look, it's for Frank Sinatra. Bring your family so it'll be a little bit better." And they all understood. Frank Sinatra came in Thanksgiving Day at 3 o'clock by himself, table for one. He said to my grandfather, he said, "Patsy, it's a little quiet today." And my grandfather didn't know what to say. He said, "Well, you know, it's Thanksgiving Day. People stay home and this and that." And he said to my father, who was the chef at that time, "I want anything but turkey." And my father made him a nice chicken rollatini. He found out later about that in life, and it really solidified the relationship. I always tell anyone who will listen to me that I think here at Patsy's we do a good job with the food. We try our best. We've been around 65 years. We keep trying to keep the reputation up. I'm only the third chef all these years, my grandfather Patsy, my father Joe, and myself. And I don't think we would be in the position we are now if it wasn't for Frank Sinatra. There isn't a day that goes by where someone doesn't mention his name. There isn't a day that goes by where someone doesn't say, "Oh, I heard Frank used to come here. I heard Frank used to like it. What did he eat?" And besides the people he brought himself personally in throughout the years, which the list is endless. So you could look on our Wall of Fame and almost any one of those pictures could be traced back to Frank Sinatra. We wouldn't be in the position we are today. We always say Patsy's is the restaurant made famous by Frank Sinatra.